think as an individual, I don't think there's been anyone like Diego Maradona.
He can do everything that all the other players can do, but better, better and better.
Every time he gets the ball, he always does the right thing. All the things that you are saying to the player to do, he does.
He intimidated our opponents by just being on the pitch. He seemed to take all the pressure off his teammates.
Greatest footballer who has ever walked the earth. And people can bang on about Pelé until they are blue and yellow in the face, like a Brazilian shirt, but it's just not right.
He won that World Cup almost on his own for Argentina.
It was Maradona? Goodness me.
There was a certain aura around him because you knew you were in the presence of genius, without doubt.
There he goes. Maradona. He's got it once again.
Maradona was a marvellous player. There isn't another player yet like Maradona in the world. And it's what, it's 16 years since then.
With the luck of the Irish, the Scotch found themselves in the group of death.
It's a ridiculous group. We played Uruguay and you've got West Germany. Denmark was fantastic at the time. I think the three of them were in the top 10 in the world. That is my excuse and I'm sticking to it.
Few for Scotland. Margaret, or Elkjaer it is, he gets free this time and he scored. Elkjaer, 1-0 for Denmark.
The game against the West Germany, you know, was a good Scottish performance.
So here we are again on the Scotland World Cup seesaw.
Scotland in the first half played a very good game and dominating a little bit the game.
This is Nicol.
It was a bright sunny day, and of course we had the curtains closed, and it was 1-0 because Strachan had scored the opening goal.
And Strachan?
I hit it early. I think the goalkeeper I thought was going to get it. We take another couple of touches. But hit it early, and he got the slightest of deflections. Wouldn't have made any difference going in anyway.
Scotland have taken the lead!
Gordon Strachan was a fantastic player, and his goal I remember as a fantastic goal.
We thought at first he was going to leap over this hoarding. But he's only a wee fella, Gordon, and you know, he started to look as though he would develop a hernia in the process, so he settled for just slinging one leg on top of it.
So that was just me checking to see if there was a moat behind it before I leapt over. Then I realised that the barrier was too big for me to leap over anyway.
What a good start for Alex Ferguson's team.
And we knew that Scotland would not be safe until they were out of that stadium with a victory.
And the back heel finds Litvarsky on the edge of the area, and they've got Arlovsen on the blue ball, and Fuller! And Fuller is a handful. He's pulling away from Neri every time, or trying to, and Neri sticking to him. And Arlofs! Klaus Arlofs has put West Germany 2-1 up against Scotland.
It was all set up. We had to beat Uruguay. Very, very difficult.
If there is one area in world football in which Scotland can claim to be past masters, it's in doing things the difficult way.
In those days, you thought, first 5 minutes, you do what you like. You could shoot your granny in the first 5 minutes and the referees wouldn't want to send someone off so early. But this referee was different.
There is a first indication of how the Uruguayans might be approaching this as Batista brings down Gordon Strachan, and there is a red card. He's off.
Lucky enough, I can sniff tackles coming like that, and I realise there was something coming, so I managed to get my legs off the ground, because if it did connect with my foot on the ground, it could have been a problem.
That foul really did deserve a red card.
Uruguay were down to 10 men within a minute, and their manager, Omar Boris, was inciting the crowd and was in serious danger of being sent to the stands himself.
It was a hopeless game. It was nothing to do with football. There's no why you're there.
And that's a free kick. And that one. Oh, late tackle, surely. Free kick. And Scotland, at this moment in time, seem to be in a kind of semi-stupor.
Well, we get so near and so far because we're good enough to get there and we're not good enough to stay.
There's Richard Goff, and the final whistle has gone. It is a particular Scottish agony experienced by everybody who's seen it all before.
Bobby Robson, oh, you know, he was a pup who cleaned my boots and based his managerial style on mine. But, you know, he led England to altitude and beyond.
2 months of tortillas ahead of them, the party tackled their last English breakfast with some enthusiasm.
The preparations went good beforehand, got used to the altitude, got used to the heat.
You're working against the best coaches in the world, and you're dealing with the best players in the world, and you're pitting your wits against the best players in the world.
I would have certainly believed that we'd win the World Cup, although there's always a realistic voice in the head somewhere telling you, actually, well, you probably won't.
Diamantino.
It's very important to win your first match. If you win that, you've got 3 points in the bag and you're halfway there.
Diamantino. Colin.
When you lose, you're nowhere. And we realised we were nowhere.
But no matter, it's Morocco next, and Captain Marvel is there. Marvellous.
Too wide of the penalty spot, but the cross is a bit overhit. Hatley, good header. Robson battling for it.
Losing Brian Robson was a huge blow. We lost him really before the World Cup because he'd gone most of that season with his shoulder out.
It was a gamble to play him, but it was a gamble worth taking.
You cannot afford, if you're going to win a World Cup, to lose your best player, even if you've got lots of them. And we didn't have lots of them.
Who's our best player? It was tragic for us. And Ray Wilkins was a very experienced player. He was good head, good, you know, good decision maker. And he got sent off.
Flag is up for offside.
He didn't throw the ball at the ref. He threw the ball towards the referee, but it hit him.
And a red card has been shown to Ray Wilkins. Disaster upon disaster for England. They lose their captain, and now they've lost their vice-captain.
All of a sudden, we've lost two captains. We're down to 10 men. We've lost the first game against Portugal. We're 0-0 against Morocco, a team everyone expects us to beat. And we're on the brink of being knocked out.
We're in a hole. There wasn't any doubt about that. We're in a fight situation. We're going to, you know, either lose and go home with 1 point. 2 points wasn't going to be enough. We got a draw, so we knew we had to win.
I think it was the fear of flying home the next day that inspired us to make sure that we got through.
Hubble. Nice little header. Quickly seized upon by Beardsley. Lineker checking back when he might have gone straight on.
We need to score first, and the first goal is always the most important. And that was a really good goal.
Stevens coming up on the right. Ball in the area.
Get the first goal, we'll be all right. We'll win this game. And when Lineker got it, you know, I probably inwardly I heaved a sigh or a relief.
They waited the time, they weighed the pass.
In training, he was very poor. He didn't like running, he couldn't shoot, he couldn't hit a barn door in training.
Beardsley looking very lively. What a lovely first time ball. Lineker far side, coming in on it. No!
There's no doubt the game against Poland changed my life. From being a guy that scored a few goals in domestic football in England, all of a sudden I was, you know, one of the leading goal scorers in the World Cup.
We're not it, lunges it, and Lineker says thank you very much.
He's in the World Cup, no bigger stage, hat-trick all over the world.
And there is
sound of delirium on the terraces.
He then went on to play Paraguay. Played very well.
There again. And Hoddle turns in a minute. What a goal for England, just when we wanted it most, with Lineker off the pitch, fiercely. Gary Stevens of Tottenham in a good position. And Lineker, yes! 3-0, surely now, England are on their way to the quarter-final.
Then on to the momentous one against Argentina.
Among the rival fans, passions are already on the boil.
Were the favourites, and they had Maradona, the greatest player in the world at that time, and our problem was, what do we do about him?
Maradona's talent could help us win any game we played, but if there's one game we wouldn't have won without him, it's the game against England.
De que sin Maradona no hubiéramos ganado es precisamente frente a Inglaterra.
So much of the pre-match publicity has been about this little man. 5'6" of him, Diego Maradona, and how England will play him.
People ask me how he's stopped Maradona. I said, well, try and kick him. If I had the chance, I would have done.
Maradona. Four England players between him and a possible pass or route to goal. Free kick against Bennett and an immediate yellow card.
When it comes to the hand of God, I've been asked so many times, did you see it? And I actually didn't see it. It was very, very quick.
Seen that much of Hodge or Trevor Stephen. Maradona just walked away from Hoddle then.
Stevie Hodge tries to flick it with the outside of his foot. We all think Peter Shilton's going to come and splatter the Argentinian who's going to head the ball. And it was Maradona.
Hodge and Maradona!
And all of a sudden the ball's in the back of our net.
Maradona gives Argentina the lead.
At that moment, I didn't worry. I thought, well, that's handball. Referee's seen that. He'll blow his whistle and, you know, it's a free kick to us.
They're appealing for offside. The ball came back off the foot of Steve Hodge.
Along with several other people in the stadium, I did not spot it. I did not know what the England protest was about.
They're appealing for offside.
I remember turning to Don Howe, my coach, my assistant. Hey, Don, I think he hasn't seen this. I think he's going to give a goal. Because by this time, the referee had gone further towards the halfway line. And it suddenly hit me that he'd actually given a goal.
That's where the ball came from Hodge. Maradona had continued the run forward.
No conozco ningún. Show me a player that after scoring a goal like that would go up to the referee and say, I think you should disallow it. I've never seen anyone do it in world football to this day.
En el mundo del fútbol.
He called it the hand of God. I said, no, it's the hand of a cheat.
There can be no question it was handball.
If I'd seen him handle it blatantly, he definitely wouldn't have scored the second goal, because he probably wouldn't have been on the pitch.
Well, the second goal was artistry. He went past about three of our players.
I was trying to chase him. I see poor Peter Reid trying to chase him. He was never going to catch him. It
has to be the best goal I've ever seen.
I'm the one that he beats twice. I'm the one that makes two mistakes.
I'm sure that in the whole history of the World Cup, there hasn't been a better goal than Maradona's. That goal encapsulates football and the beauty of the game.
A lot of people have said it was an own goal, but it wasn't an own goal. If I had the chance to claim it as an own goal, I would have claimed it, just to deprive him of the chance of scoring the best ever goal. But, you know, hands up, it was a great goal.
And there is a very dejected man. Beaten once unfairly, beaten on a second occasion, like so many of his colleagues, by sheer skill.
You have to throw something at them that they're not continuing with at the moment.
And on into the World Cup for the first time comes Watford's John Barnes.
I told Bilardo that Giusti didn't know how to defend against John Barnes. And he said that if he didn't know, then he'd have to learn.
This is John Barnes. That's nicely done. That's a good cross. The carry of Lineker! And England.
2-1, back in the game. And I didn't want the game to end. And then I remember another cross, almost a replica cross, from John Barnes.
And every Englishman surely would be saying, go on, run at them.
John Barnes gets another great ball in. I can see it all the way, and I know it's beating the keeper. And I'm just a few yards out, and I know I'm going to score. It's in. And I can see it, and I watched it all the way onto my head. And actually saw myself hit it.
One of my worst nightmares is the ball Olati Kotsia saved with the back of his head from under the bar. At the time, I thought it was in. England had scored and they'd taken the ball from the back of the net because mentally I'd already accepted it.
Still to this day, every time I see it, I wonder how it didn't go in because I just knew I was going to score.
No time to think, the throw has to be taken. But the whistle goes and England are out of the World Cup.
People say I'm a poor loser, but I'm a bad loser. I hate losing. I detest it with a passion.
I was just sick, saddened, gutted, disappointed, not feeling very well. All of those feelings, you know. Felt sorry for the players, you know, sorry for the fans, you know. I could think about my father and, you know, sad.
Apparently there were some games where Maradona didn't play.
Well, the Hungarians have really attacked it. But what a splendid strike! The countering. Yes, what a chip by Frank Bekouteren. Platini's made a run for the France have equalised. In front of him. Is he going to backheel this for Adino? He is. He's walking in. And it's white side.
Hype was, are they going to be as good as they were in Spain? And it's hard to relive something like that.
Not sure what they're going to do. Now it's played. Zidane. Oh, and it's in. Mitchell. Oh, good ball forward for Buchetino. And Spain has scored in the opening few seconds. Zico. Can he get to that? Oh, I say.
We were on the wane as a squad as such, and I think we bowed out gracefully.
So here we are again at the World Cup final, and our two favourite nations battle it out to be number one in our hearts. Magnifico!
Maradona was a head of the Argentina team. If we can control Maradona, there is a good chance to win the final.
It's what the Germans did was to sacrifice their best player, Lothar Matthäus. Didn't like it, but he was told, stick to Maradona like a limpet.
For 45 minutes, Matthäus followed Maradona around the pitch, so they cancelled each other out.
The yellow card's been shown, looked like Matthäus, for the foul on Maradona.
The free kick came over, Brown got the header and scored.
In a normal day, it was easy for a goalie to catch the ball, but unfortunately he wasn't in a good day.
That miss eliminates Schumacher from the title of best goalkeeper in the World Cup 1986.
I couldn't believe it. We'd only played 20 minutes. This was my World Cup. I said to myself, this can't happen.
So that was the lead for Argentina, 1-0.
Maradona. That's the speciality pass that they have, of just moving the ball on to the next player.
When I got the ball in the middle of the pitch, I controlled it comfortably. One touch with my left foot. I didn't touch it again until I stroked it into the back of the net. They say in football that a goal is more the sum of control than the shot. I think this goal is a very good example of that.
So we was 2-0 down after, I believe, 50, 60 minutes. And then we came back because our team was very good prepared by Franz Beckenbauer.
Bremer has gone across to take the corner. Driven, Fuller, Rummenigge, goal!
I scored it 4 meters from the goal, and with this 2-1 we came back in the game.
And the cross for Hernes. Now the goal came from a corner on that side.
I've never been in a team that spent so many hours in training, learning how to defend corners. And in the final, Germany scored twice, both from corners.
Alemania nos metió los dos goles.
Bremer curls it awkward. Oh!
We did feel more fresh. Argentina was afraid, Argentina was tired, and then we made a big, big tactical mistake that we probably pushed too much.
There were only 8 or 9 minutes left. Maradona picked up a pass in the center and gave it to Burruchaga.
Burruchaga
is through for Argentina, can he do it?
If it hadn't been a goal, I would have killed Burruchaga, as would 30 million Argentinians. But it went in, and he was a hero.
Entró.
It was the only game where Maradona's fellow players had a greater role to play. If it wasn't for this game, you could have said that he won the competition by himself. Thanks to this game, he almost won it on his own. But not quite.